Hello my gorgeous friends, welcome to my channel. As you have seen from the thumbnail, this is all about gel nail polish at home. I would be telling how you can apply gel nail polish at home for fraction of the cost you pay at salons and what all you need to take care of and what all you need. First and foremost thing for gel nail paint is a LED lamp which has LED bulbs underneath, something like this. This is from Sun UV. I would leave the details in the description box. I would tell you the tips and tricks and also the difference between regular and a gel nail polish. So watch till end. We will see everything. And these are the stuff you need. I shall tell you one by one. First thing you need is a cuticle cream to soften your cuticles. If you don't have a cuticle cream, you can go with Vaseline. Apply it generously all around your cuticles. Shape your nails. I generally do square nails and this is personal choice, you know, subjective to person to person. Then the next step, if you don't have big bed nails like me, the length of the nails are not big, then this cuticle cream or Vaseline would help you to push your cuticles back. This nail filer had the cuticle pusher, so I'm using it. When you're pushing your cuticles back, you should remember that you should not harm them. If it pains, that's the point where you should stop. You should not cut your cuticles. Generally, doctors ask you to avoid it. And then the next step would be taking any acetone of your choice on a cotton pad and then dehydrate your nails. Tip number one, the cotton pad you'll use should be quilt free. If you have quilt one, then there are chances that it may leave the quilt on your nails and you may polish them with the quilt. And then later on, your nail paint may chip. Then I've taken a buffer, I'm buffing the nail bed. Tip number two, when you use the buffer should have fine grit, else you will spoil your nail bed. So remember, the buffer should be gentle and then again, use acetone and wipe off the dust, which you may have after buffing and filing your nails. Then take the base coat. Base coat should be applied at each and every corner of your nail. This will ensure the nail paint is stick to it and would last for long. If you avoid this step or you miss any part of your nail, then there are high chances that the nail paint may chip before 3 weeks. The layer of the base coat should be absolutely thin. After that, hold your hand something like this that the fingers are pointing towards earth, so there is no product on the cuticle. And then I've taken the same nail filer. If you don't have a pointed nail filer, then you can take a toothpick. Clean any product which is there on the cuticle. If you don't do this, then there are absolutely high chances that the nail paint will come off as a sticker within few days. I'm just cleaning the cuticles, anything which is there on my skin, ensuring that when I treat my nails, nothing comes off after like couple of days. At this point, I'm also looking for any bubbles or any lint which is there on my nail. I'm cleaning it with a thin toothpick. After I was happy, I placed it under the LED lamp. I treated it for 30 seconds as it was mentioned on the manual of the nail paint. Now I've taken a red LED nail polish, a classic color. I would apply a thin layer of nail polish all over from my nails. While I'm applying the nail polish, I'm looking that nothing comes on my skin. If your base or nail polish or your top coat comes on your skin, then is the chances, then are the reasons why your nail polish gets chipped off, your comes off. Alright, the second reason which I've seen why people don't get their nail polish pay off for 3 weeks is, you apply thick layers of product on your nail. There should be no thick layer of any product on your nail. Now I'm trying to show you here how I apply nail polish. I start little over the cuticle of my nails and then I take it down to the end of the nails, and when I'm doing it, I'm generally pushing the brush back to my cuticle. It's a to and fro application. You just have to remember, you never start from the cuticle, you actually start little bit over the cuticle. Once you're happy with your nail polish application, take a toothpick, clean the cuticles again. Remember, nothing should be over your skin, so be very careful while applying the gel nail polish and then again monitor it. If there's anything on your skin, clean it. Once you're satisfied with the application of nail polish, hold your hand pointing towards the floor and then treat your nail polish. Remember, you have to read the manual which comes with your nail polish, how many seconds a minute it should be treated. If you over treat, then there are the chances you crack your nail polish. If you under-treat, you know what will happen. The sticky layer won't go off. And then you will have those marks, or maybe, you know, getting it together or sticking it anywhere. So always read the manual. And after you've treated your nail paint, comes the time for the top coat. So the top coat ensures the nail is shiny for weeks. Nail doesn't chip off from the front. That is why when you apply the top coat, there is an action called sealing of the nail polish, like so. Did you see what I did? I'll apply the nail polish and then I would run it vertically over the edge of my nail so that I'm sealing the color, and then if it hits somewhere, my nail hits somewhere, or I'm doing some work, my nail polish won't chip. Apply a thin layer and then hold your hand pointing towards floor so that nothing is there on your cuticle. Everything runs down. Treat your top coat. Read the manual, girls. Read the manual. Yes. Never under or over treat your gel nail paint. Wait for the seconds, the minutes the manual has come up with. So by now I've told you every trick which you have to do. But do you know there's another last very important step which you should do so that the sticky layer which there on the top coat will get eradicated? I will tell you. I will tell you that step, and I will tell you the difference between a gel nail paint and normal nail paint. Take a acetone, dip your cotton pad, and then run over your nails. This step will ensure that there's no sticky layer on your gel nail polish. Now I'm showing you an OPI normal nail polish, and the difference of the shine between a gel nail polish on the right and the left is a normal nail paint. Now I would show you the acetone wear off test. This is a cotton pad dip in acetone and I'm rubbing it over the gel nail polish. It won't go anywhere. The shine is still there. Now I would do it the same thing on the regular nail polish. Wait for a couple of seconds. I would do it. Yeah, I have shown you another finger of gel nail polish. Nothing moved. Now the other normal nail polish finger. Did you see? The product vanished. So this is the difference between the gel nail polish. You can do this at home at a fraction of cost. You just have to be just a little bit careful and the tips and tricks I've told you. And then you would get 3 weeks of beautiful gel manicure at home at a fraction of cost, as I said. And until we meet next, kindly like, share and subscribe my channel. Take care. Bye-bye.